There are already some pre-configured value descriptions on the board, and in this video I will get these value descriptions from the board, and I will also configure a new value description on the board. And for this I select the board, then I go to the value tab, and here I click in the value description remote section on get all. A table appears, and this table contains all value descriptions that are already configured on the board. And in general, you can have virtual and non-virtual descriptions. Non-virtual descriptions are fixed, that means I cannot change them. And you can recognize these non-virtual descriptions easily by the virtual column here. If the checkbox is not activated, the value description is a non-virtual one. As you see, all the value descriptions I got from the device are non-virtual. That means I cannot change them. As you can see, if I go into one of these fields, you see I don't get a selection, so I'm not able to change anything. Every value description I add myself and configure will be a virtual one, and this means I can configure it, I can change it, and if I want, I can also remove it later from the device. So now let's add a new value description, for example, for a counter. For this, I go into the value description local section and I click on add. A new row appears. It is already filled, but I can change it as I like. And you see the checkbox under virtual is already activated, so this will be a virtual value description. Since I would like to add a counter, I enter counter 1 here. Then under type, I select the appropriate type, and this would be counter 2. So, under mode, I will keep read-write because I want to get information. I also want to set information. And for example, if I wouldn't add a counter but a temperature sensor, then read would be sufficient because I only need to get the measured temperature. Under persistent, I keep not persistent. If it's very important for you to store the data in a non-volatile memory, you should select persistent, because in that case the data will be kept even in a power failure or something like that. For me, this is not important, so I keep not persistent. Format number is also okay. Under min and max, I can enter the minimum and maximum values. I will take 0 and 8, for example. Step 1 is for me also okay. If we get back to the temperature sensor example, then 0.1 would be a good idea. Unit, I don't need it, and max length is also not important for me. You can enter a restriction here if you like. The last two columns, reported value and set value, don't refer to the value description. They are for getting and setting values. So I locally configured my counter, and now I can send it to the device by going to the value description section and clicking here on set all virtual. You see the red frame around my board appears again, and also a message, a status message. This means I configured something on the board, so I have to save it, and this is done on the home tab. Here I click on save. And if I now get a value description from the board by clicking on get all in the value description remote section, you will see that my counter is still there. This means my configuration was successful.